96 News This Hour.
I must congratulate them for doing this. However, it's quite unfortunate that it had to take the time it had to take. I really wish that this came out a little earlier because we didn't have to go all this way for selfish gains.
Article 37 is very clear, and the Constitution has not been suspended, and no one has the capacity to suspend the Constitution or any of the articles. And, we are where we are because when we plan Maandamano, there is also government-sponsored thuggery.
96 News Now with Teddy Otieno.
A very good afternoon and welcome to the broadcast. Students who met at the university cut-off points will be placed in public universities. Appearing before the Public Investment Committee, Education Cabinet Secretary Ezekiel Machogo stressed on the directive unless parents or guardians decide otherwise.
We have said government competition, government grants. No government grant is going to a private university. That one, we have made it very clear from this year, and the placement is going to be aside. Unless you, probably a Kenyan who is able, and you say you want your child to go to a private university, that is the only way it is going to happen. Otherwise, we have said, and it is now policy of government, that funding will be done. Grants will be given only to public universities. That is clear, and that is the way it is.
Earlier, the CS noted that the ministry is also making changes to the criteria for capitation, adding that universities in the country have a collective pending bill of 60.2 billion shillings. Speaking of which, this scams of students joining private universities are set to miss out on capitation this year. They will, however, be eligible for student loans, courtesy of the Higher Education Loans Board. The students will be sending the applications to the Kenya Universities and Colleges Central Placement Service.
Students who join private universities will qualify for loans from the Higher Education Loans Board. They will, however, not qualify for scholarships from the government of Kenya. The scholarship from government will only be limited to students in public universities.
Agnes Wahome is the chief executive, Kenya Universities and Colleges Central Placement Service.
Once the universities have given us their costs, which I hope they will do in a week's time, we'll be ready to open.
Former Kiambu Governor Ferdinand Waititu has been barred from disposing of assets and vehicles targeted by ESSC in an asset recovery suit worth 1.9 billion shillings. Now to some politics, and members of parliament have weighed in on the move by Azimio to call off demos. Welcoming the move, Molo MP Kuria Kimani, however, said the bipartisan talks ought to have kicked off way earlier. On his part, Makueni Senator Dan Manzo noted that peaceful protests are guaranteed by the constitution, even as he pointed an accusing finger at the government.
I must congratulate them for doing this. However, it's quite unfortunate that it had to take the time it had to take, because by the time they're calling off protests, we had an entrepreneur who had his bus burnt down to ashes along Gong Road. We had a truck that was burnt down. We have police officers that are dead. We have innocent Kenyans that are dead.
I can assure you Article 37 allows Kenyans to demonstrate, and I remember very well in 2003 the Honorable Ruto and his team then in opposition organized a very big protest in town, and the President Kibaki allowed them to go on with their protests. So Article 37 is very clear, and the Constitution has not been suspended, and no one has the capacity to suspend the Constitution or any of the articles. So there is no blackmail. Protests can be conducted now without destruction and without problem. And we are where we are because when we plan Maandamano, there is also government-sponsored thuggery. And I can evidently call it so.
In Migori, police are probing an incident where a man was lynched by members of the public after he allegedly killed his expectant wife. The incident happened in West Kanyam cargo location in Uriri. Area Assistant Chief Charles Onindo say that the bodies have been taken to Migori Level 4 Hospital mortuary. Elsewhere in Kirinyaga, where two people were found dead at Ngurubani in Mwea East, the two reportedly lynched near Wangoro Stadium, is Area Police Boss James Mutua.
Hawa watu wanjulikani na wananchi wa area hiyo wanjulikani, uchunguza hawajulikani. Na pia hiyo mbonda mbonda inasemekana ndio walikuwa wameiba hatujaipata pale. Tunashukuru hawa watu ya, ni kama walimetoka na wao kutoka mbali sababu wanjulikani katika area hii. Na ile habari tumepata pia ni kama watu walikuwa wanafuatana na wao.
Bodies of the two have been taken to a nearby mortuary.
Tulistuliwa asubuhi na kitu yenye tumekuta watu wawili wameletwa pahali tu huwa tunabebea na mbonda mbonda. Wameletwa wakiuliwa, mmoja alikuwa hajakufa kabisa lakini yamemaliziwa hapa. Inaonekana kuna mambo yenye hatuwezi kuelewa.
Tuko hapa kwa sambambu tumepata kuna watu wawili waliuawa usiku na tunjui ni kina nani waliwaua. Na hiyo jambo linatustua sana kwa sambambu hawa wenye kuwaua hata tunjui ni kina nani, na inaonekana walikuwa watu wengi. Maana hao watu ni kama walipigwa vita, na hii mambo inatustua sana bwana Mulika.
Well, now across the board.